Hey, what's up everyone? Welcome back to Fahrenheit. So last time we interrogated Lucas. Kind of succeeded, I guess. Well, we have new evidence, so... yeah, we're supposed to get wine or something and glasses, I don't know. Champagne.
Did you get the oven going and pour the champagne?
Yeah, I'm on it right now.
Don't tell me she'll be naked. Okay, she's
Hello,
wearing a dress.
Hello, Detective Miles. Do you know what day it is today?
Well, we already had Christmas, so 4th of July? No, that's summer. No, you got me.
Tyler.
Okay, babe. It's been exactly 2 years since I met the woman of my dreams.
You want to put some music on? I feel
no,
like dancing.
I don't. I don't like you. You're strange. I swear, if more funky music will play... Oh, Beyond Two Souls. Oh my god. It's their love-making music. Oh, I failed.
Tyler.
I'm a police officer, not a dancer, woman.
Looking back over my years, I guess I shed some tears. Told myself time and time again, this time I'm gonna win. For another fight, things ain't right, I'm losing again. Takes a fool to lose twice.
Okay, just stop dancing. I want to continue the story and not watch them dance for 5 hours. Finally. Oh my freaking god. At least they're not showing it. I hope so, because last time I thought they wouldn't show anything. And I was surprised, let's say that.
Tyler gave me a full report on what happened at Nazer and Jones. He emphasized that one of the employees was behaving strangely. A guy named Lucas Kane. Now, I had all the pieces of the puzzle. I just needed to put them all together to find our murderer. On my desk lay all the information from Nazer and Jones. On Tyler's desk, the clues from the restaurant. The identity of the killer was here somewhere.
Okay, let's find it out. Examine.
The Shakespeare book found in Lucas Kane's desk at the bank.
Do I memorize it? Richard III. Do I have to compare it to the other book?
The Shakespeare book found at the suspect's table in the diner. The two books are from the same collection and have the same dedication. They obviously belong to the same person. I've got my first link. I'll need another in order to establish proof that Kane is our man.
Who's calling me at this hour? Oh, wrong phone.
Detective Valenti.
Hi, Carla. It's Garrett. I called to tell you that I sent you the results of the testing we did on the prints on that pen. They should already be in your email.
Perfect. Thanks, Garrett. I'll take a look right away.
The taxi company should have sent you a list of taxi destinations from the same street as the diner the night of the murder. It should be on the fax in your office.
Thanks. Bye, Garrett.
Bye, Carla.
Do I check my computer? Sure, why not? Let's see.
Lucas Kane's fingerprints.
I mean, I don't know what I can link it to, but so I can try maybe this. Oh, obviously. Is that his
the killer's prints found on the murder weapon? No doubt about it. The prints from the restaurant and the pen come from the same person.
So he did.
This time, there's no reasonable doubt. Lucas Kane is the restaurant killer. I've got to tell
the restaurant killer. That sounds funny. Okay. What am I supposed to do? I didn't hear her say. Am I supposed to call Tyler? I swear, if he will be doing that dirty... Oh my god, yes, interrupt them. Go, Carla. I don't want to hear her moans. Throw her off of you.
Sorry, babe. I need to answer it. It might be important.
Tyler, no!
There's a murderer out there.
Hello?
Shut up, woman.
We got him, Tyler.
I'm on my way.
Tyler, I'm warning you. If you leave me now, I will never forgive you.
Oh my god.
I won't be long, babe. Just sip some champagne and I'll be right back before you know it. I'm sorry, Sam, but this is really important.
What about me? I'm not important? Tyler!
No. We just left her on cold ice. And I love it, because I don't like her. She's too annoying.
The noose is tightening. The police are closing in on me. They'll be back, and next time, they'll take me in. Agatha was my last chance. She's the only one who seems to understand what's happening to me. I just hope this time, she'll give me some answers.
She's gonna be dead. I can just smell it, feel it in the air.
Agatha? Agatha! It's Lucas!
Someone just went out the window.
Sir, I need to get your name before I can record your message. Sir, the police cruiser will be there in just a few minutes. Can you hear me, sir?
Agatha!
Oh my god, no, we're... I need to raise his mental state somehow. Is he going to commit suicide?
That's the end of my story. I suppose I wasn't strong enough mentally to be able to bear what happened to me. I decided to give myself up to the police. I'll finish the rest of my days in prison. And I'll...
Should I not check her body? Escape. The way he just looked back.
New York police. Anybody there? Hey, Kevin! Call an ambulance! There's a body on the floor!
Okay, now everybody will blame us. I thought I was going to have to start this all over again. But apparently not. This is a different scene. Great. Don't tell me we'll kill another person. Or are we seeing through the eyes of that...
Sorry,
his nails.
We're closed. Come back tomorrow.
Oh, I won't be long.
Oh, he possessed another person. He'll probably kill that woman standing over there, right? I think that's a woman. I don't know. Oh, run, miss. You will die. And again with a creepy girl. Jeez. She gives me the creeps.
Finally put all of the pieces together. All that's left is to arrest the killer. Captain Jones has given us everything we asked for. There's no chance of him escaping.
Oh really? He's not even there. If you're at his office or
everybody in position.
Or his apartment, because I doubt he'll be there. Oh, I think they're in his apartment.
I'll go in first. You cover me.
This is his apartment, right? What the hell happened here? Why is there a satanic circle on the ground?
Damn, what the hell
is
this?
And there's writings on the wall. Oh my god. Runes?
Cover me. I'm gonna check the doors.
The toilet first. Oh. There's blood, but I doubt Lucas did it. It's probably that guy that possessed him, right? At least I think so.
We missed him. Well, he's running now.
Ugh. What the hell am I supposed to do now?
He's running across the street. What should I do, Carla?
Stop him. We're coming.
Copy that.
It happened again. Somebody died in the lavamatic. I saw it like I was there. Agatha's dead, so who's gonna tell me what's going on?
Put your hands in the air!
Damn, the police. They already found me.
Oh, please tell me I'll
spend the rest of my days
to fly around
prison,
and beat them
and
up.
I'll never find out
like I did
really
that
happened.
Punching bag.
No.
Oh, get
it's
ready.
It's not gonna happen like that.
Oh, hell no. I ain't going down without a fight. Hell yeah, Lucas, show them. Your Jedi powers. This is literally the Matrix. Neo, is that you?
Stop or I'll shoot!
Oh, I'll dodge all of your bullets.
Don't move.
I'll outrun your cars, choppers, whatever. Oh my god. Now this is what I call an action sequence. Hell yeah. Did we escape? Kind of, I think. Oh, not yet. Oh my freaking god.
Did you see what that guy just did? Shit, that's crazy.
We need to catch him. Next time, he won't get away.
Oh, I doubt it. He will get away with powers like that. Let's control Carla.
Five men in the hospital, four wrecked squad cars, a helicopter that just missed blowing up in our faces. Meanwhile, the killer takes a nice quiet ride on the subway. I hope there's a good explanation for all this.
Nothing went according to plan, Captain. The operation was set up by the book and everybody did their jobs, but Kane displayed some abnormal abilities.
Just what are you trying to tell me here? That this guy is Superman? That's your excuse? And you seriously expect me to buy that crap?
Taylor.
Captain, we're not amateurs. If this guy was a tourist, we would have cuffed him and stuffed him in no time. We underestimated him. He's a lot more dangerous than we thought.
I don't give a crap about your two-bit excuses. When the press finds out that Kane slipped through our fingers, they're gonna make me a laughingstock, and the mayor's gonna come looking for my head. Now, what is the plan, people? Are you on his trail?
Yes, we are. Not really.
Kane's photo will be in every squad car, train station, and airport. We're going over every inch of his apartment and interrogating his associates. He can't stay hidden forever.
I want every available man on Kane's ass right now. I want him locked up tight in 48 hours or less. You understand me? I want this nut job behind bars before he decides to cut somebody else. Now get out of here!
Carla, I've been looking for you. We found some of Kane's prints in an apartment where we found the dead body of an old lady. And that's not all. There was a double murder last night in a lavomatic. One of the two victims was killed by knife blows to the heart. Garrett's already there. He's waiting for you.
St. Paul's Church. I'm still gonna control her.
-5 degrees Fahrenheit. Every day it got a little colder. The whole city seemed to be numbed by the snow and ice. But nobody was worried about it yet. Go take a look inside, Tyler. I'm gonna talk to Garrett and see if he found anything.
Cool with me. I can't even think out here in this damn cold.
Ah, I was waiting for you, Carla.
So, what happened here?
The guy who runs the lavomatic found the bodies around 5 o'clock this morning when he came to open up. When he tried to get in, it seemed like the door was blocked from the inside. He saw the two bodies through a window and called the cops.
What do we know about the victims?
The man was called Jose Lopez. He works here and was supposed to close up last night. The woman's name was Anita Martinez. She did her laundry here on a regular basis.
Were there any witnesses?
No eyewitnesses. We checked around the neighborhood, but didn't turn up anything. This guy got lucky. He commits a double murder in front of a window, and nobody sees a thing.
Thanks, Garrett.
Oh, how little do you know that he didn't do this, actually. The only murder that he didn't do, well... Oh, a card. I guess I have to walk around.
Three or four stabs in the area of the heart. Exactly like the victim in the restaurant. I wouldn't be surprised if the autopsy finds that the arteries were severed. Did you notice this blood over here?
Yeah, I saw that. What do you think
it
means?
Oh, he has a knife in his eye. Ugh.
That the murderer was bleeding before he stabbed his victim.
So he actually just killed like himself in the eye. Oh, that sounds painful. Very, very unpleasant. Which are literally the same thing.
A knife stuck in his eye. Death would have been instantaneous. Bizarre. His wrists are all cut up. Looks like some kind of symbol carved on them.
A two-headed serpent.
Snake. A snake with two heads.
One head in our world, the other in the other, or whatever he said. Do I switch to Tyler? Do I speak to him? Wait a second.
The knife has the same handle as these other tools. It must have come from this toolbox.
Wait a second, I can also check.
Bizarre. Why is there blood here? Is this where he cut up his own forearms? Cain left some blood in the toilets, too. Did Cain cut his arms up, too?
Okay, so I don't know if I'll find anything. Maybe something's outside.
I want to check on a thing or two before I leave.
Okay.
Let's go. I've seen enough. What are we supposed to think about this murder? The guy committed suicide after killing the woman? It seems absurd,
he
but
did.
It's the only explanation. I don't think Cain had anything to do with what happened at the laundrette. But, all the same, there's got to be a link between the two murders.
Is Agatha still alive? Is it her spirit talking to me? Is this the same church his brother works in? I guess I don't know how I should say it. Will all of the seeds start flying into me? Oh, hello there.
Agatha? Agatha, is that you? I thought you were...
dead. In a way. But I promised to tell you what I know. And I always keep my word. Listen carefully, Lucas. We have very little time. You are not insane. Neither are you a murderer. You were simply at the wrong place, at the wrong time.
Then who made me commit that murder? Who came and sat down at my table in the restaurant?
No one knows his real name. They call him the Oracle.
The Oracle?
He serves the most powerful of the powerful. They live in shadow. But they have controlled this world since the dawn of time.
Visions.
Why do I have these visions? They are real, aren't they?
In a way, yes. They are using the visions to try and eliminate you. You've seen too much. So you've become an inconvenience. They're coming! Save yourself, Lucas! They want your life! Kuetnitlan, in the ancient Mayan civilization. You'll find some of the answers you seek there.
Agatha? Agatha!
What the hell? The statues are coming alive. Now angels will attack me.
Thank you.
This game is absolutely crazy and I love it. Let me go.
Lucas, wake up! What are you doing here? What happened?
Sleeping, dreaming out.
The police found me.
Dead women.
I managed to get
angels
away.
Trying to carry me away somewhere.
I didn't have anywhere else to go.
I don't know.
I came here. My God. This time you really have to go to the police, Lucas. There is no other solution. I'm not turning myself in until I understand what happened. Something strange is happening to me, Marcus. Since the murder, I find I can do abnormal things. I see visions of certain events before they happen. Sometimes I can even hear what people are thinking. And my body has become much stronger and faster.
Nobody has powers like that. You're not turning into a Superman, Lucas.
You don't trust me, you know.
I saw Agatha again. Here, just a while ago. She's dead, but she had some things to tell me. I think she wants to help me.
Agatha is dead? Are you telling me that you...
No, I didn't kill Agatha, Marcus. She was dead by the time I got there.
But you're saying that you talked to a dead person? None of this makes any sense. So what are you going to do? You can't stay here. The police will certainly come to question me, and probably place me under surveillance.
I have to find some place to hide. I'm a fugitive. My description will go out everywhere. At least now I know that there is an explanation. I need to find the people who are behind all of this.
Be careful, Lucas. They'll kill you if they get the chance.
Nothing could be worse than what I see in my visions. Agatha talked about the Mayans. It's vague, but it's all I've got to go on. I've got to find a place to hide while I figure this out. There's only one person who can help me.
Okay, so I guess I'll end this episode right here, everybody. I do hope you enjoyed it. Please like and subscribe if you did. I hope you have a great day. Goodbye.